Hey guys, what's up? Casey and Brendan here, back for week 9 of our Smash Blog update coverage.
Yeah!
We got mostly a lot of Echo Fighter clips this week.
If you hear
an
echo in the room, it's because this week is full of a lot of Echo Fighters.
Echo. But we also got a new stage and a new Pokeball Pokemon, which I am very excited about.
Possibly the best music ever.
Actually, yes. I'd say the best.
Yes.
The dudes are hot. But first, Richter from Castlevania, which is the Echo Fighter from Simon Belmont.
Mm-hmm. We talked about him a little bit last week. He shares most of the same moves with Simon. I haven't seen any real differentiations except for his holy water is blue, not red.
Well, then the holy water explodes into fire, which is then blue.
That means, doesn't that mean that all of the other Smash characters are demons?
Yeah, I think that is an
realization. But a lot of the moves you see that Simon and Richter share, some of them come from Richter originally, because in Rondo of Blood, which he first debuted in, he had a lot of more melee attacks, that slide kick, the backflip, the uppercut. Those are all Richter specials. Another cool thing that one of my friends mentioned to me is that his poses come from Rondo of Blood specifically. His icon, like character pose, where he's got like the fist up, that's from the box art of Rondo of Blood. And if you notice at the end of his character trailer, when he has his windscreen little pose, that's actually from a part in Rondo of Blood where he saves a nun named Terra, and there's a small little cutscene, like anime style, and he turns back and he goes like, eh. And like that whole pose is right from Rondo of Blood. It's kind of cool.
I wonder if anyone just pulled that off the top of their head, or if they had a search for a good pose for him. Yeah, Which one do you think it was?
What did we make him do? Maybe like they had just like, hey, you're a big Castlevania fan. What would you do with Richter? Oh, make him do that pose. That's the one. That's the cool guy pose.
So that's all we know about Richter so far. He's very similar to Simon, as Brendan said. Mm-hmm. But next we see Abra. And Abra has actually appeared in the intro movie in Melee, but this is the first time we're seeing him. He just like jumps up with all the other Pokemon. Mm-hmm. But now we get to interact with him, and he does something pretty cool. Abra will come out of the Pokeball and then teleport people somewhere randomly on the stage. And Brendan,
You say it's cool. I say he's a jerk. He actually appeared at one of our very first E3 demos that I went to. We were playing Amori Towers, and someone throws a Pokeball. I noticed he's floating around. He kind of floats around from the stage for a bit, and then when he finds someone, he starts to cast Teleport, and whoever's close when that thing hits gets sucked into him. He then will move to usually more than one location. Like, he moved to the left, and then to the right, and then just dropped me off. And I had no idea where I was at that point. By the time I realized where I was, you'd see me falling off the stage going, oh, I should up B. Oh, well, too late.
So it sounds like you can make the fight very chaotic.
You have to really pay attention if you notice Abra's on the stage. Like, if you disappear, look around, because you're going to appear somewhere that you probably don't want to appear in.
Avoid the Abra like the plague. Also, fun fact, Abra in Japanese, his name is Casey.
No way.
It is. It's spelled C-A-S-E-Y.
You heard it here first.
Letters.
Casey confirmed for Smash.
Yes, I am in Smash as Abra. So, next on our list, we have a new stage from Castlevania, Dracula's Castle. And we got to see a little bit of this in the Smash Direct last week, but we had a few more details since then?
Yeah, I mean, this is one of the four new stages we've seen so far. The other one that we haven't really seen too much of is New Donk City. But yeah, this is the one that has kind of like these stairs at the bottom right corner that lead up to a main platform with two floating platforms, and sometimes a candle will appear, and in true Castlevania fashion, you can break it to get an item, kind of like how the one-up or the question mark blocks work in Mario stages, which is kind of a neat little thing. The biggest part about that stage, besides it being so dark, is that there's a chance that a random Castlevania boss will crash through the stage with a stained glass window in the background to fight you, and that can include Medusa, the Mummy, Death, who killed Luigi, the Werewolf, Creature in the Flea Man, also known as Frankenstein, Carmilla. And they tease two more characters at the end, one of which was Dracula, which we see him in more of a boss arena. So I don't know if he had to maybe have a boss battle fight before he can show up, because that guy was very kind of like vague, like, oh, I can't tell you how you unlock him.
Yeah.
So he may not show up until you do something like that. Also, there was a ? Silhouette, and that threw me for a loop. It was kind of like a spiky hair person. Mm-hmm. Oh, that's not Goku, right? No, it's not Goku. Turns out it's Kid Dracula. And you may not have heard of him because he actually comes from a Konami parody of Castlevania called Kid Dracula, in which you play as a little chibi Dracula boy going to fight this crazy demon thing. And you go around through like the castle, you go to the desert, you go to like in the city, it's you can turn into a bat. It's really, really weird. It's just like a parody spin-off game.
So what kind of moves do you think we can expect from Kid Jocula as we fight him as a boss?
I have no idea. Like, I know you can use fireballs when you play as him, and you can turn into a bat, so some variation. But yeah, this is a very odd choice, and I can't wait to see how he actually, you know, moves. I'm assuming that kind of like how Yellow Devil and Metal Face from Xenoblade stages, like, if you KO them, do you get a point in your favor, and how tough these guys can really be. This is also one of the stages that has 34 musical tracks, which I'm very excited for.
So just to clarify, Kid Dracula is not officially confirmed yet, right?
No, they had a silhouette, and that's pretty...
And the silhouette matches.
He has this really crazy white spiky hair in the game, so I would say that's him.
I think if Kid Dracula is in the game, I think that's awesome because it means other really obscure characters might be in Smash.
Oh, yeah.
So I'm super excited to see what else we're gonna see that's that obscure that so few people know about. So next we have the best music that we mentioned.
Gangplank Killian!
And it's real good.
Oh my god.
And this has a rap section.
This is electric. I am so blown away by this music. I wanna jam out to this every single day. This is forget Final Destination. This should be the song that plays at the end of Evo when there's just the final matchup. I don't even care about the commentators. I just want this music playing. This is such a good track in a way that I didn't think was possible. We've heard a lot of like metal variations of Gangplank Galleon, and like those are all great. This is like straight up like mariachi, like trumpets, like and brass. Like I really like. And like you said, there's a rap section. Like forget DK rap. We have K Rool rap.
It's so much better.
So this was composed by the musical duo called Ace. That's comprised of, I want to get their names right, Tamori Kudo and Hiro Chiko Yamanaka. And they worked on Xenoblade series. I highly recommend you check out their music. There was actually a Nintendo video like behind the scenes of them composing for the 3DS version. Check it out because it looks really awesome. They even did some music for some other Smash games. I think they did the Fortress Boss remix for Smash 4. But yeah, this is like a really cool take. Someone even asked David Wise, the original composer for Donkey Kong, what he thought, and he was like, oh, this is awesome. Yeah. I'm so happy to see, like, I would never thought that this track would be remixed to include a rap sequence. People are still trying to figure out what the lyrics are. They're very, like, subdued, which I'm okay with. Definitely but listen to this on repeat.
The horns are so catchy, the theme, and it's so hype.
It's so good.
Really good. You should definitely go listen to it. It is King K. Rool's theme, right?
His boss theme from the first game.
It's really good, and there are already a lot of memes out there, like King K. Rool doing the trumpet kid
trumpet
to
kid.
Ashley and Waluigi, which is really good. A-plus stuff. So that's all we know about that track. Really excited about it. Again, go listen to it.
More.
And next up, we have Crom, who is an Echo Fighter for Roy.
Yeah, this is kind of funny. He was first introduced in the last Smash game on the floor as Lucina was fighting Captain Falcon. So Lucina and Robin had their debut while he's just knocked out in the corner going like, oh, I guess today's not my day. And it's like, all right, he's like, no, it is. As a final Smash assist for Robin, you don't get to play yet. So he finally got to make it and into a playable fighter. But it's very strange that considering him and Lucina are kind of identical, he actually takes more after Roy than he does Marth because of his giant blade. And most of his attacks are like Roy's, with the exception of his up B, which is Ike's Aether attack, which is very strange.
Can you explain to me the timeline and family tree of all of these Fire Emblem people?
No.
No.
I will not attempt to. They're all across different generations, but the only ones that really related are Robin, Lucina, and Crom from Awakenings. But yeah, it's really weird because as an Ike player, I'm kind of worried for Crom because his Aether and his final smash is also kind of like Aether, but instead of doing an uppercut into the sky, he has an uppercut and then jumps back and then lunges forward, which is a very weird variation. But as an Ike player, his Aether attack is a very vertical recovery and goes straight down. So if you can't reach the stage, if you're like not under it, you can't really get back. And luckily, Ike players have his side B, which dashes across. Mm-hmm. So if you get knocked away far away, Your up B isn't going to help you. Your side B will. Yeah. Crom doesn't have that. He still has Roy's Dancing Blade,
yeah.
which doesn't really give you a whole lot of side movement. Mm-hmm. So recovery for for Crom might be a problem. I don't know how Sakurai's going to balance that.
Yeah, I mean, what did Roy players do?
I mean, Roy players had Mars up B, which is his Dolphin Slash, which has a little bit more horizontal movement than Ike's Aether.
Yeah.
So yeah, it'll be interesting to see how he really plays.
Yeah, interesting. So lastly, we have another Echo character, Dark Samus from
Metroid. Dark Samus. Can we just give a round of applause for Dark Samus and Little Mac, who are the only assist trophies to make the leap to playable character? Maybe next time, Waluigi. I'm sorry. And Ashley.
Yeah.
And Shadow. And
King
everyone else.
King K. Rool was a trophy, not an assist trophy, though.
Yeah, that's true.
Just a regular trophy, which is even worse than an assist trophy.
Yeah, so again, just like Crom, Dark Samus takes a lot of inspiration from Samus, with a notable change being that Dark Samus floats off the ground, which is a pretty cool little thing, and that her dodges don't use the Morph Ball.
Mm-hmm.
She just, you know, floats to the side, and she still uses a Morph Ball. I don't know if it's she or it.
So it's weird because Nintendo keeps referring to Dark Samus as it, and it really throws me off.
I'm pretty sure there was a trophy for Dark Samus that said she.
Yeah, but now they're saying it, and usually when Nintendo does stuff like that, it is on purpose. Like, you know, we're calling Abra he, that's wrong. It's an it. Abra isn't it.
there's a weird terminology going here. But yeah, anyway, when Dark Samus uses its bomb attack, I kind of noticed that it was a little more horizontal movement range than vertical with Samus's Morph Bomb, so I wonder if that'll play into things. But yeah, other than that, the only really big change is like cosmetically changed. The Super Missiles and Homing Missiles have a kind of like a creepy infested look to them. But other than that, it's an Echo Fighter, different version of Samus.
Between the more floaty characters versus the more like tight and heavy characters, like say like Fox compared to Mewtwo, like what kind of characters do you prefer to use?
I'm usually either very fast or very slow. Like I like Ike and Ganondorf, but I also like, you know, Sheik and Link.
So let us know in the comments if you prefer more floaty or less floaty, and if you're going to use Dark Samus or regular Samus or Richter or Simon Belmont or
Crom or Roy.
Yeah, let us know.
I use Ike. He's the better choice.
He's the better choice. I mean,
they're Ike's all good.
We like Ike, but okay. Roy's our boy.
I like that.
That's all we have for you today for this week's Smash Updates. Tune in next week for more Smash Updates, where Brendan will be doing this all by himself because I will not be here.
What?
Anyway, thanks for watching, and for everything else Smash, keep it here at IGN.
See ya.